Hare Krishna. Fighting self-destructive desire by ourselves is like fighting a forest fire with bare hands. We all have different kinds of desires. And some desires we can easily resist. We feel like eating something, say, I'll not eat it. But some desires become self-destructive. For example, when an alcoholic, when a person becomes alcoholic, then the desire for alcohol is self-destructive and it is obsessive. It overpowers the person. And when the desire comes, it seems almost impossible to resist that desire. It's an inner torment that seems like a blazing fire within us. Krishna talks about this in the Bhagavad Gita in 3.39. And he says, Avritam jnana metena jnanino nitya vairina kamarupena kaunteya dushpurena nalena cha. So he says that this self-destructive desires, what do? They cover up our knowledge so that we can't, at least when the desire is attacking us, we can't see what is good for us and what is bad for us. Avritam jnana metena jnanino nitya vairina. And this, Krishna says in very scary terms, that this is our eternal enemy. Why eternal enemy? Because normally if we have an enemy, that enemy may hurt us, at the most they may kill us. But the desires within us, they will chase us lifetime after lifetime. Nitya vairena. They will never go away on their own. Kama rupena kaunteya. That kama rupena. They are in the form of kama, selfish desire. Dushpurena nalena cha. They see, they are insatiable like a blazing fire. Now suppose, if we are in a room and suddenly fire is lit. We look for a fire extinguisher. There's no fire extinguisher. If we have to fight the fire with our bare hands, we can't. The more we try to fight it, the more we get burnt. And if the room is closed and we can't run away from anywhere, from it anywhere, then we will be tormented. So similar is the predicament of people who are on fire within because of the torment of desire. And just as when there is a fire, there is a vital need for fire extinguisher. Similarly, we all need a fire extinguisher. And that fire extinguisher is Krishna. When we strive to become conscious of Krishna, when we focus on remembering Krishna, then as we experience the higher peace and the higher joy of remembering Krishna, then the lower desire can be doused. It can be extinguished. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita later that Bhayasparsheshvasaktatma Vindatyatmani Yatsukham Sa Brahma Yoga Yuktatma Sukhamakshayam Ashnute. That when we focus inwards to our spiritual essence and to the supreme spiritual reality Krishna present within us, and we start experiencing imperishable happiness thereof, Sukham Akshayam Ashnute, then Bhayasparsheshvasaktatma, then the external sensual pleasures, we become indifferent to them. So when self-destructive desire starts overwhelming us, rather than feeling guilty because of that desire, rather than feeling hopeless because of that desire, rather than trying to fight that desire by our own and simply getting burnt more, we can immediately turn towards Krishna, take shelter of Krishna, call out His holy names, remember His message, strive to busy ourselves in His service. And by that fire extinguisher of devotional remembrance of Krishna, we will be able to overcome our self-destructive desires. And Krishna will take us from self-destruction to self-realization. Thank you. Hare Krishna.